Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Spring Anderson University Wind Ensemble Concert. Off to a great start, am I right? Yeah. Bravo, bravo. I'd like to welcome all of our audience here tonight, and of course our online audience as always. And I'd also like to welcome a few special guests that are with us tonight. We are privileged and honored always to have President Pistol and his wife here joining us this evening. We also have many, many distinguished music faculty, and I cannot thank you enough for your support, for coming out and spending your evening with us here. And it means so much to myself, as well as the students. And the students, if we could welcome very special guests to you all, which would be your family members who are here in the audience, and also personally, my parents who came out tonight as well. Can we give them a round of applause? Bravo. These students have worked so hard to prepare this program for you tonight. We really hope you enjoy it. I'll talk very little and let them be the stars of the night. The first piece was Anthem for Winds and Percussion by Claude T. Smith. We call that a chestnut of the wind band literature. We're going to do another one, just a traditional piece, written in memory of the actor James Dean, who starred in three really blockbuster films and then died tragically in his 20s in a car accident not very far from here in Indiana. And this is Larry Dane's piece in honor of James Dean, As Summer Was Just Beginning.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Our next selection is by a piece by the well-known band composer Frank Ticelli. It's entitled Simple Gifts. It's in four movements, and it's going to be a number of traditional folk songs that you may recognize, including the Aaron Copland classic, Simple Gifts. We hope you enjoy Frank Ticelli's four movements of Simple Gifts. Thank you very much, and just a wonderful job by our soloist and small chamber music players in that piece. Just a lovely, lovely job. For those of you who are fans of the classic wind band literature, I have bad news for you. We're about to go into the 20th and 21st century, so it's going to be a little bit different, a little bit new, so just be prepared for that. We'll do these two pieces back-to-back pretty much. The first one is a slow piece by Steve Bryant, who's an award-winning composer, one of the leaders in the wind band composition world right now. And it's a piece entitled Dusk, and it really does paint a picture of the dusk and that time of day. And then we're going to follow it up with John Mackey, who's another cutting-edge composer and writes a lot of really edgy things and clever things, and is a really brilliant guy. And you would never know by the stature of him that he is all of 5'2". Because he writes such grandiose and, to be blunt, in-your-face music. And that piece is called Foundry. So Steve Bryant's Dusk, followed by John Mackey's Foundry.
Thank you.
The saying goes, time flies when you're having fun, correct? The last piece that we have on our program tonight is written by a good friend of mine by the name of Mark Lortz. I actually did some graduate study with him back on the East Coast at the wonderful Peabody Conservatory, and he's written this piece that I actually had the privilege of doing back on the East Coast earlier this year with an all-district band back in my hometown. That was really an honor and a privilege to go back and do that. This is another contemporary piece, but it's a little easier to digest than the John Mackey tune that we just went through. This is entitled The Heart of Madness. It's based upon, it's semi-programmatic, based upon the poetry of Edgar Allan Poe. So you hear three different chunks of it. The first is based upon the bells and different types of bell themes that you'll hear. In the middle, we hear the raven, based upon the poem The Raven. And then the final theme is based upon his poem The Telltale Heart. In fact, you will hear the heartbeat motif all the way throughout the work today. So again, thank you for your support and being here and supporting these wonderful students and their hard work that they've put in all this year. And we hope that you enjoy Mark Lortz's The Heart of Madness.